If you want to upscale your images to a better quality and you're tired of those pixelated, crappy looking images, I'm going to show you how you can smooth out your images and upscale them and enhance that resolution of that image to make it even better. Especially if you're doing any type of design work, you want to leverage an upscaler like this one. And if you get any value out of this video, make sure you guys give this video a thumbs up. So I have the Aiarty downloaded to my desktop. You can see right here, AI image enhancer. I'm gonna go ahead and double click on that, and it's gonna go ahead and open up. Right now, it's pretty simple to use, which is really nice. One thing I look at when it comes to any of this stuff is like some tools can be a little bit overwhelming and a bit confusing. So literally just drag and drop an image in there, and then you can start the process and upscaling your image. But so for example, over here on the right hand side, you see the hardware. You can pick any of these CPU, your graphics card. I'm just gonna go ahead and pick my graphics card right there. And then if you want to mess with any of these, you can do that. But I'm going to go ahead and hit the more detail, this one right here, just showing you exactly how I'm going to use it. And then you can upscale right here. So it depends how you want to do it. I'm going to just go ahead and keep it at the 4K that I have it at right there. To pass processing, you can, if you want to mess with any of that, I'm going to leave that unchecked. Okay. And then I'm going to come over here and I'm just going to drag and drop an image that I have. Let's go ahead and grab this one. All right, now it's literally just drag and dropped it and it's upscaling it already. You can see it working right here. All right, now you can tell the difference right off the back, and I love how it shows this is the before and this is the after, and you're going to see that it shows you like the dimensions right up here. And if you look real close, let's go ahead and you can zoom in over here too. So you can zoom in to the part of the actual image so you can get an idea. So this is real cool. This is really user friendly and easy to use, as you can see that. So we can zoom in a bit and you can tell the difference. From the left to the right. And if you can't see that on the screen, I can definitely tell the difference right here by looking at this. Even if you zoom out, you can see the detail work a bit better. And if you like, let's zoom into the eye, you can see it. So this one is obviously more enhanced after the process of doing it. But then if you don't like, let's say you want to just do it a little bit more enhanced, you want to do 8K, you can do that. Okay. Just clicking that button. Let's go ahead and hit processing the whole image upscale. All right, you can definitely see the difference, right? Big difference now. See that, right? It's more clean. It's pretty nice. And this is a cool image too, by the way. You can see it's a tiger. I went ahead and just dragged and dropped another image right here. You can see how I, right here on the side, you can look, select three different images right there. I changed this back over to 4K, and yeah, look at that. Just see the quality of it. Now let me go ahead and just grab another image. See how I just drag and drop? See how user friendly that is? All right, so we went ahead and just did three images, and you can just tell too, like, you see the pixelation right here on this boat, and you see over here, there, it's not there no more over here. So it enhanced the whole image, right? And just the whole, refined everything, we cleared up everything. But now keep in mind, there's with this AI type art stuff, some of the actual design part of it, you can see that this right here, and this is a big question that I get in the community a lot. And people always ask, like, how do I get these lines more refined and better? Gotta take a little bit of human power on your end. If the lines are not good, AI can do as much as possible, but sometimes their lines are just messed up. And this is just a perfect example. Like the upscaler did its job here, right? But there's certain parts out after you upscale it, right? Then you come over here into photo editing software. You can use Illustrator or any type of, you have your own pen on your iPad. You can just redraw this or hire someone and they can go ahead and redraw this part right here of the boat. But this is a perfect example because you're using that to upscale the actual image. And then when you upscale the image, you're going to see like little flaws, right? And that's normal. Let me go ahead and grab seven images right there. Seven images. I'm going to drag and drop it here. Now it's working on all of them. Okay. You see how easy that is? That's really cool. Okay. Click over to the next one. Next one. And you can just drag and drop them all right here. Next one. Pretty cool. See how it got a little blurry on the left, and then it just made it all nice and clean. Pretty nice. Zoom out, right? As we can see. Yep. And then definitely too with the writing, you see it. See how it's all pixel like blurry? And then it just cleans it all up. Same thing here. just makes it cleaner. All right, and that's at 4K. So you can actually, like I told you, you can upscale it to any of these, and you can even do your own custom resolution if you wanted to. But you can tell the difference in those images. Now, how I uploaded each one too as well, you can add an image one by one, or you can actually add the whole folder. Let me go ahead and show you exactly how what it looks like when you add a whole folder. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and hit this little trash can right here. It's going to go ahead and clear all of this. Clear it all. I'm going to go here, hit add, and I'm going to go ahead and add the folder. And then I have Aiarty2. I'm going to select that folder. All right, and then it's going to go ahead and start working for me. And you see how fast it's going. All right, really looks, let's zoom out. Look at that. Pretty cool. Some cool ones here, right? Now look at that. Tells a big difference. Now, also too, if I want to export any of these, I just hit the run and it's going to go ahead and drop it into another folder with all these images. It's going to pop up and share that with you. All right. So they're onto my PC. Come over here, click on that, and there are the images. So you can do that with any of the images and see how I did it. Okay, they're downloaded onto your PC, and they're all upscaled, which is really cool. Let me go ahead and pull this out. I can add text to any of these images if I wanted to. So there's all the different fonts here. All right, I can change the font, lion, and then change the color, sizing, anything I want to do like that. So I can do any of that. So if I zoom out, if I want to add the font in there, I can do something doing that. All right, so that's pretty cool. I can edit all the font, add the text, add some text in there if I wanted to, or do anything like that. Okay, so one way I think is when you're using this type of software, you have to keep in mind that you have to have an okay computer to actually run this, like this type of hardware on your PC. Keep in mind, like you can't be using a really outdated PC if you're doing, that just applies to any graphic design, right? Any, if you're doing any type of graphic design, if you have a older PC, it's going to run slower. Just keep that in mind when it comes to any of this stuff. Now I'm going to go ahead and clear this out. I'm just going to clear all this out. Go back. This is the area too, when you're uploading your images, or like where you're working from right here. Now I'm going to go ahead and add a image that I found off of Facebook, and it was really pixelated. It was a good example because I was like, huh, this is a good one because I know that it's really pixelated and Aiarty is going to help you enhance the image even more better. This is the left and right, right? So left one is a before and this is after. You can tell a big difference. Okay. Also, if you can change like the way the layout is, if you want to compare the two, you can definitely do that. You can see how pixelated it is, the before one, and then the after just cleans it all up. I like this way better though. So you can see exactly, this is a very good example right here because it's like stuff like you find on the internet from years and years ago. And then you doing this right here and then coming over here and leveraging AI Upscaler to help you enhance these images even better to give you a better results with your, either your, let's say you're doing any type of design work for a t-shirt, or you're designing a certain product packaging or anything like that. Or even if you're leveraging like any type of AI art and then posting these on social media, but you're leveraging an upscaler like this to help you get a better image to post on social media, which I'm pretty sure the social media platforms enjoy better quality images on there because it's a better experience for the customer. But it's a very powerful tool. If you're not using this or testing this out, I highly recommend you use to help you make a better design, better product, whatever it is that you're selling. And if you're unaware of what Aiarty Image Enhancer is, I showed you that how I had it downloaded onto my desktop, my PC. If you come down here, you're going to see pretty much the breakdown of everything about the Aiarty Image Enhancer and everything that it does and what you can do. And you can see the example that I shared with you in this video. It's a very powerful tool when it comes to enhancing low resolution images and making them so much better. So you can see some of the examples that they use here, right? Especially with pixelated images. If you're still unaware of exactly what I'm talking about, you would definitely test this out because it's going to help you as far as understanding the quality of your image, okay? And the one that we did was the more detailed they're smooth, diff, and the real photos. Depending what you're doing, right? It all depends what you're doing. Each one's going to be different, but you're going to see that you can definitely mess with certain models over here. So you're going to see the breakdown each one. And here's the pricing too if you want to buy Aiarty image enhancer. Okay, standard license, beard build yearly, $75. And then lifetime license, one-time payment, lifetime upgrades, $99, so $100. And then the cool thing too, license to 3 PCs, so you can use this on 3 different PCs. The only difference here is standard license is yearly, and then lifetime license is basically $24 more, and you get the unlimited over here. And it does the whole breakdown and all that information. So if you want to sign up for it, my link's going to be down below in the description. So make sure you sign up for it. If you want to change your images and enhance them even more than what they are right now, and you want to see how I create designs leveraging AI, watch this video right here. Thank you very much for watching, and give this video a thumbs up. Peace out.